In blocks, we refer to user interface elements such as text, images, input fields, and buttons as bricks. A brick can only be added within a block. This means in order to add a brick to a page, the page must first contain at least one block. To add a new brick, simply select one of the current bricks within a block and click either the top or bottom insert button to reveal the brick bar. The brick bar is filled with various elements that can be placed within a block in order to build the user interface of the web page. To add a brick, all I need to do is click it. Because I selected the bottom insert button to access the brick bar, the new brick was inserted below the previously selected brick. If I had selected the top insert button, the brick would have been inserted above the previously selected brick. When a brick is selected, the inspector on the right side of the design canvas will be populated with all of the relevant controls that allow me to customize the brick's appearance. From here, I can make various adjustments and apply additional characteristics, such as scroll effects and animation. To delete a brick, I'll simply select the one I want to remove and click the trash button located in the top right corner of the inspector. Alternatively, you can delete any element with the keyboard shortcut Command Backspace. Finally, it's worth noting that it's also possible to install additional bricks in order to expand the possibilities of the types of sites you can create with blocks. You can find many additional first and third-party bricks at the Blocks store.